Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Simply Learn. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about Ansible All You Need. This is a prerequisite knowledge, which is basic understanding of Linux Windows operating system. Okay, let's start. What is Ansible? Ansible is an open source community project sponsored by Red Hat. It's an automation tool that can be used across entire IT teams, from systems and network administrators to developers and managers. Ansible is an agentless push-based automation tool. Ansible uses YAML to write automation codes. YAML is yet another markup language. It's a markup language, yes. Okay, what is Ansible? It's a community project, open source community project sponsored by Red Hat, okay? And it can automate your entire IT infrastructure using Ansible. And one of the beauty of Ansible is it's an agentless push-based automation tool, which means you don't need to install any agents to work with Ansible on the servers. You need only the Ansible management server with passwordless SSH authentication. Let's go to the pictorial view of Ansible. Here we have Ansible management node here, and we use playbook and inventory. I will explain the terms in the upcoming. Okay, here we have Ansible management node, and which uses this playbook and inventory. These are the codes that Ansible that will tell Ansible management node to what to be executed on my hosts. Here we have my servers here, server 1, server 2, server 3, or server n. And what Ansible management node will do? It will read the code, playbook and inventory, and based on the instructions we have given in the playbook and inventory, it will execute the tasks on this, on our servers, n number of servers. You can have hundreds of servers here, and you can execute all the tasks on n number of servers simultaneously. And as I said, Ansible work via SSH, no master server, no agent required. There is only one management node, that is basic RPM of Ansible will be installed on this management node. That's all what you need to start with Ansible. Okay, let's go to my preparations. One is, I have a few documents here. One is the basic documentation. Second one is, we will talk about only what we need to start with using with Ansible. We don't talk many things. There are many things that you need that we have in Ansible. We talk what we need to start with Ansible, and you can write your own codes for your IT infrastructure by end of this course. That is the idea here. And here I'm showing you the demo using my first Ansible playbook, my second Ansible playbook, and my first Ansible role. This is the agenda here. Here first, let's open this documentation. Okay. Here, I explain what is Ansible. Ansible terms. Some of the Ansible terms that you should be in on for. Okay, here, what is controller host? The host where Ansible is installed. Ansible tasks will be triggered from this host. That's what we saw in the picture. Here, inventory. A file that contains information about the servers we need to manage. This file will have the data about the servers where we want to deploy the codes, deploy our codes. That is the inventory file. Here it's playbook. Here we define automation tasks in YAML format. Here we do all our automation codes in the playbook. Task. a block in playbook where we define a procedure to execute on the remote host. In a playbook we can add n number of tasks. Okay, it's a task. Each task will have a specific objective, which means each task will be some task for installation of some RPMs, some tasks for creating some directories, starting some services. That could be a task. That is a task. Okay. Here it's module. Ansible ships with a number of built-in modules that is used in playbooks to simplify our job. Ansible has, there are thousands of built-in modules available in Ansible. If you see here the URL ansible.com, Ansible list all Ansible modules. Here we have these many modules readily available in Ansible that we can use in our code. Okay, there are n number of modules, and if we want to see one of the module, I'm just finding copy. Okay, here, not this one. Or service. Bin service. We have bin service here to execute on Windows, and there are many services. I will go to here. Here we have service, manage services. If you click this, we will see what are all available in the service module. This is one of the module that is frequently used. Okay, here this is the argument. It's an explanation of what the service is. We can use these arguments and choices. What are the options available in the choice? So we don't need to remember all the modules, but we need to know where we can find the help for this. We can find here, and we can find for the module that we are going to use. And here we have a very good explanation of what is this module and where we can use this module. Here it's using for service start. Okay, this is a module. I will explain this in this session later. Okay. And here it's a role, a predefined way of organizing playbooks and other files. It's an organization of the playbooks. We'll be explaining this in later. Play is an execution of playbook. Okay, it's when a playbook is executed, we will say it's a play. Facts, global variables containing information about the system, like network interfaces or operating system. It's a global variable that Ansible will gather when we execute a playbook from the remote host. Handlers. We will be explaining all this in deep. Okay. Handlers. Handlers are just like regular tasks, but only one if the task contains a notify directive and also indicates that it changed something. So handlers is a task, but we will be using for handling some changes. So if there is any changes in some configurations, these tasks to be executed, in that case we can use handlers. Templates are processed by Jinja 2 templating language. Templates a file out to a remote server. We will be discussing this about all these templates. Okay, now let's start install Ansible. Okay, I have two hosts here. One is Ansible management and another one is host 01. Okay, I will do all my Ansible playbooks and management installation of Ansible, everything in Ansible management host, and here in host I'll be deploying some kind of tasks in this host from this management server, Ansible management server. So this is my Ansible management server. First of all, what I need to do is install Ansible.
I have already installed it. So using yum, I'm using CentOS, CentOS 7.6 in a VirtualBox. Okay, just for your information, and we can use yum install Ansible for installation of Ansible. I have already installed it, so to save time. Okay, there is an updated version of Ansible available. I don't want to update it now, so I will just give no, and let's check my Ansible. What I have? I'm using Ansible 2.4.2. Okay, this is already there. So let's move to next Ansible command line. Okay, first, what I have already told that we need to enable passwordless authentication between Ansible server and remote host. So the SSH should be passwordless. If I try to access my host 01, yeah, I don't need to provide any password. So I have already done this. You want to you can use this command as copy ID localhost or the host name of your server. Okay, I'm not going to explain deep into that. So we need a passwordless authentication between the host Ansible server management server and the remote servers. Okay, let's start Ansible command line. Here we have Ansible the usage of Ansible. Okay, this the Ansible command options. Here there are many options. I'm not going to explain this now. Here we will straight away start writing playbooks. Okay, and this is the Ansible playbook command, and there we have many options. Here you can go through this and when you have free time or when you're trying this. Okay. And this one is before executing this command, what we need to do is we need to specify the host in etc Ansible. This is the default file where Ansible will look for the inventory. We will discuss about inventory again, and here at the end of this file, these are commented lines. At the end of this file, I have added my remote server host name, which is host 01 under my servers. This needs to be done that we will discuss again. This is the inventory. Here we start the inventory, and if we have there is one local, which is local host, and this is my server. I will explain you again this later. Okay, that I have already done. So let's execute. This is the Ansible command. Instead of writing playbook, you can run this command to execute some tasks on the host 01. But this is not normal. No one will use this. Okay, this is to see the facts that we were discussing earlier. Whenever an Ansible playbook or Ansible is triggered from the management server on to a remote host, first it will gather the facts of the machine that is here. Here we have many things that Ansible is gathering from the remote machines. So it will be useful. It will be Ansible will use this whenever they need in the playbook. Some of the useful facts or global variables is host I grep for hostname, let's see. The Ansible hostname. If you want, this is a variable. We can use this variable inside our playbook. If we want to get the variable, get the server name where we are executing this playbook, we can use this. We'll be using this in our playbooks. Don't worry, don't about that. Okay. That's usage of Ansible command line. Now let's start using Ansible playbooks, which is very very important. Okay. Closing this. I'm going to my first playbook. Okay, here it is. Okay. Okay, let's start with our first playbook. I'm creating a directory with some name like this. Okay, I'm going to this directory. Okay, here we will create our first playbook, which is create a simple playbook and run on a remote host. Run means we are running this playbook on the remote, the tasks playbook will be run on the machine where we have Ansible installed, which is Ansible management server, and the tasks will be executed on the remote host that we will specify in the inventory file. So what all we need is, first we need to create a YAML file which is basically the playbook. I'm going to open this and let's explain what we are going to do with this playbook. Okay, it is the indentation in this playbook is very very important. If you miss the indentation, then there will be a syntax error, the playbook will not run. So this starts with a basic format like this. We start with this is the start of the playbook, which means the start of the playbook, and for each task, this is one task, first task. This is the main task actually. This is not the first task, this is the main task, my first playbook in Ansible. And we mention where we will run. We mention my remote hosts. This is the inventory. This information, Ansible will get this information from the inventory. And here we start our tasks. This is our first task, which is create a simple directory. I'm creating a directory called create a folder home Sunil. And here we are using the module called file. Okay, file. If we don't know what is this module, we can go to this module section, and let me find this. We have it here. Just it's a Ansible documentation, and here file, and there are many modules. One is file. I'm clicking the file module, and this is the documentation about file. Okay, here these are the parameters that we can use, and the choices and the description about this. You can read this if you don't know about this module. And here the nice thing is, here they provide some examples. So normally if I need to read about some modules which I don't know, I will just look into the examples. From here we will be able to understand for what this module is using. Here file, this is the module name, and path means this is the file that we need in the remote host. Okay, and owner, this is a self-explainable, explain the group and mode. Okay, and if you want to create a directory, what we will do, it's using the same file module, and the state will be directory. So if we do not like that, see this is the state. This is the state is an argument, and this is the directory here. So if it's directory, means it will create a directory. So that's what we are going to do. This is the help documentation where you can find all this information. Okay, let's go to our playbook, which is file, which start, which is the name of the file, which is home Sunil, and state is directory. I need a directory here, which means we can specify the state as directory, mode, which is 755. This is the permission of the directory. Okay, we use chmode in this is same here. Okay, in Linux, this file, this is not this file is here, and here we are going to create a user. So I'm going to create a user using a, this is the name, this is a description, this is commented, and this is a, it is better to have a description here to know what we are executing. When running the playbook also, this description will be displaying in the screen. Okay, here the name of the task is create a user, and I'm using the module called user. Okay, and these are the attributes, these are the arguments or attributes for this user module. For user, we need a name to create a user, which is Sunil, and this is a command. When we execute user mode command, there is a option to provide command, that is the same thing here. And shell, which shell the user should use, which is bin bash. And home directory that we have created in the previous step here, that is a home Sunil. I am going to give the same, the that one as home directory. And UID, we are specifying some UID. If you want, you can specify. And if you, these are optional, the name is the only one which is required. And if you go to this documentation part here, it explains it's optional or it is mandatory. See, this is required. Required means this is we need this, else the we need at least one parameter, which is a path. So without path, if you just give the module name, it will fail, because at least it need to know what they need some input from us, right? Okay, here the name of the user is must. Without a username, we cannot create a user. This is a basic simple logic, the same logic they we need to use in the modules also. Okay, and in the, if you check for the user module, this will be a mandatory session, the others are optional. Okay, the next task I'm going to do with this playbook is assign a pseudo rule. Okay, I'm using I'm adding a pseudo rule for this user I have created, which is Sunil. Okay, and I'm using a module called line-in file. Okay, these modules are the frequently used modules, so I'm including all these modules in a playbook, so you'll be at least you'll be knowing these modules can be used for this purpose. Okay, I'm using lining file. There are thousands of modules here that we cannot document, or we cannot make a tutorial for all these documents, but you can check in this documentation of Ansible, where we have, it's not only for Linux, it's AWS mode. There are many AWS modules, there are Azure modules, there are big IP modules, there are many modules here, and some of them for many for Windows, VMware, HP hardware, many things. We have many modules here, network, firewall, switches, Cisco switches, many modules we have here. Okay, I use a few modules which is useful for Linux. Okay, line in file module, and here we use this module to update pseudo host file, and this status person, that is okay. And what I'm doing here is the state person means this the line, the file should be present. Okay, that's all. Okay, and if the file is not there anyway, for all Linux there will be sudos. But if you use a line file module for some other purpose other than sudoers, we can use this option to make first create. If the file is not there, you will create the file first. And here I'm using a regular expression which is starts with Sunil. This means this if you know the basics of scripting, and it is you must be knowing this. Okay, I'm using the regular expression parameter for this line in file module, and I'm filtering for Sunil, starts with Sunil. Okay, that is the username where we need to edit the update the sudoers or add the sudoers. Here this is the line I'm going to replace or add. It will, if there is already a line called Sunil, it will update it, or if there is no lines, it will add a new sudo role with the this is my sudo role, this is the line I'm going to add or update. So this is how we update sudo roles using Ansible. Okay, this is the next one is install a package. Okay, this is one of the frequently used module in Ansible. We have a module and we have apt-get if you have other debian versions of Linux. Here I have CentOS, so I use the module. Here this I'm going to install httpd. Okay, and I'm going to use module yum. And what we need, this yum is the module, the all are in same format. If you know one, then others are very very easy to understand. If you just understand one task or one module, then it is very easy to understand the others. It's all are in basic, all are in similar format. And here name, what does it mean? This is the name of the package. Yum is for installing the package, and this is the name of the package that we need to install. Okay, and here we are giving state equal to present. If you state equal to present means absolutely, this is this means it will check for yum pack yum httpd package using yum and make it present, and it will be installed, and it will make sure it is installed. That's all. If it is already installed, then no action. If there is no package called httpd, it will install it. Okay, let's go to the module. We can just check one more module in the documentation. Here I have yum here, yum manages packages with yum package manager. There is one more module for yum repository to update the repository. Okay, here we have the parameters and the choices. Okay, and if you see the yum name here, this is the name, the package name or package specifier with version. Okay, let's go to the examples. Here this is the one we are using, state latest, which means it will update if this if there is any updates available, and it will make sure that latest version of httpd available in the repository will be installed on the server. And here we can mention a number of packages. If you have 10 packages to be installed, you can provide the names. This here is a variable, this is a vars means variable, and in the packages these variables are declared as these packages, and these packages we are calling here, and all the packages here will be installed with this command, with this task. Okay, there are many examples here. Okay, we can use many of the yum which is one of the one mostly used. Some of them will be already used. It's just skip broken. We can use that option, yes or no. If we need to use that, what we do here, we will add skip broken and a colon equal to yes. Instead of present, it will be yes. Instead of this, it will be skip broken. So it's easy to use. You can add many features if you have a specific configuration or you need to update this. That I'm using the basic ones here. And next one is I'm copying a file, static file. This is a static file. I will explain you what is a template in the next playbook. Okay, I'm copying a file index.html. Okay, and I'm copying it to var.html. Okay, and this is the root directory of my HTTP server. I'm going to deploy with this in this playbook, and the ownership, group, membership, chmod, everything. Okay, that's we already explained this. Next, I'm starting the service. I'm starting the HTTP service using service module. There is a module called service in Ansible. Okay, here is the name of the service, and here it will make sure the service is started and enabled. Enabled means you can see the documentation for more details, but enabled means it will make sure it will be started across the reboots, like CHK config in Red Hat 6 or CentOS 6 or systemctl enabled, which means the service we need to enable across the reboots. That's what I'm going to do with this. Okay, first that is the playbook we are going to create in my management server. This is all the playbook. Okay, till this. Now we need an inventory file, right? We discussed about inventory, so let's see what is inventory. Inventory here, this is the name. Here we can mention localhost 1, localhost 1 here, and here localhost 2, localhost 3, a number of servers. Okay, and this is a group of servers. Suppose this is my remote host, and suppose I have one more group, my web servers, and I have one more group, which is my DB servers. So suppose why we need this kind of things in the inventory, which means I have web one and web 2. That's all, web 2 here, db1. This is my host name, host name of the service, db2, making it short. Okay. Suppose, okay, so this is the playbook what we are going to do, going to run, and this is specifically only for my remote hosts, which means these tasks will be executed only on these three hosts, localhost 1, 2 and 3, and these servers, it won't bother about these servers, it won't even check about these servers, because we mentioned on the hosts as my remote hosts. Suppose I have a few more tasks which needs to be executed only on my DB servers, like installation of MySQL or something. So we mention this MySQL, sorry, what is that? My webs, sorry, my DB servers here instead of my remote host, and create, and the tasks will be different for the DB servers. We will install DB and some other stuffs, configuration, database, etc. So the tasks will be updated based on that, and that tasks will be executed only on these MyDB servers. So that's basically an inventory file. So we will be creating a basic inventory file here. I don't do anything other than this, and here all the tasks will be executed on the server group, which is called my remote host. And I have only one host here, which is not localhost, which is host 01. Okay, that is the inventory file. Then I run this playbook using this command. Okay, let's do this. Okay, I'm going to create a file in my management server. I'm going to create. I prepared this playbook before. before starting session to save our time. When I'm preparing this during the course, it will be it will take more time. So I don't want to waste your time here. Just wasting here. Okay, the same one that we explained here. It's here. Okay. So this is our playbook. My first playbook. And we need an inventory file. Okay. So we create inventory with the name inventory. And I'm putting only one server group, server hosts, which is host 01. That is our remote machine where we want to deploy the tasks. Okay. Now let us check. Let's run this playbook. Sorry, this is wrong. Inventory. Our name is inventory. Okay, and playbook name is my first playbook. Okay, this is the syntax. Ansible playbook hyphen I to specify the inventory file. And here, my first playbook. This is our actual playbook. Okay. Let's run this and see what will happen. First, this is the gathering facts. Here, it is gathering facts about the host, about our host 01. This is the name that of our whole task. Which is my first playbook in Ansible, and each task is executing here. It's first of all, it is creating a folder called home sunil, and here it's creating a user called which is with the name sunil, and here assign a pseudo role to the user. That is also done, and now it's installing httpd package. Let's wait for this. Okay, this installation is completed, but it is failed to do this task. Which is I could not find index.html. We don't have an index.html. We didn't create any index.html here. So that is needed to copy the file. Okay. This here, if this is source is index.html, in the source index.html is missing, so that's why we are getting this error. Okay, then let's create the file index.html. This server, this web server is installed by my first playbook. This is the description I'm going to give. Okay, now we have an index.html here. Okay, it's fine. Now we try to execute again. You can see a small difference here, which is here. This is a create home folder. Earlier it was changed with yellow color. Here it is green color and it says OK, which means this is already done by my previous run. I don't need to do this again. Okay, Ansible is intelligent to check these things. Okay. And till here, this is green, which means the task which has already executed won't execute again. Okay, it will check whether this task is already done or not before executing this the task. Okay, and from here, this is yellow, which means we haven't executed these two steps, which is copy a file and start the web server. Okay, this is done now. And this is the play recap. Here host 01 OK7 changed it to unreachable 0 failed 0. From here we can see If you have 100 servers and it failed on one server, it will be failed one, something like that. Okay. And what I need to, okay, I think we have run the our first playbook, my playbook on the host 01. Let's check whether our tasks have been executed on host 01. Let's check first the RPM is installed, HTTP D. Yes, it's installed. Now let's check systemctl status HTTPD. Sorry, HTTPD. Yes, this is active and running. Let's check our index.html. HTML is created. Yes, this is what we have done. Okay. Now let's check whether our web server is accessible. Let me check IP of the server. IP. Okay, let's go to the browser. Now, yes, this web server is installed by my first playbook. So our first playbook is created. We have created a new playbook. We have updated inventory. We faced. We run the Ansible playbook and we faced an issue, we resolved it, that's all. And we run it again, it's success now. Okay. Okay, let's go to our second playbook, which is a bit, it's not, we use some variables in this playbook, some Jinja templates. The tasks are same, but what we do is do some variables, some kind. I will explain this, and we use Jinja templates, and we use handlers. We use all these features in the Ansible in this playbook. But basically, it is doing the same thing that we have done already on host 01. Okay. Okay, and what I will do offline is I will restore the host 01 to its previous state to run this playbook again. I will come back again. I'm pausing my video now. Okay, I have restored my remote host to its previous state to ensure the tasks that we have executed in our last playbook is cleaned up. Okay, let's check a quick check of the RPM is there or not. No, it's not there. So let's check ls/var www. It will not be there anyway. This because this RPM is not there. So we have cleaned the host to its restored to the host to the previous stage. The reason is we are going to execute the same tasks with a second playbook that has more features that I explained here, which is variables, Jinja templates, and using handlers. So let's explain the playbook first. Okay, here same thing. We start with the syntax and the name. I have changed that my second playbook in Ansible using variables, Jinja, and handlers. Okay, here we declare remote host. This exactly same thing what we did in our previous playbook, and here we here this is the difference in the playbook. Here we first we declared hosts, then we declare vars, handlers before tasks. In the previous playbook we don't have these two, which means that is a basic one. Here we add some features that this will be useful if you want to reuse the code. So if you write a static one, then we can use only for that specific purpose. But if you put some variables instead of giving static values, we just need to change the variables. I will explain this. Okay, and here the tasks are exactly same. except we call the variables. Okay, here declare till this, it is all same. Here we declare vars, we start with vars. If you want to declare a variable, we start with vars. If you want to declare host, we start with host. If you want to declare handlers, we start with handlers. If you want to declare tasks, start with tasks. Okay, and these are my variables. This is user Sunil. Instead of Sunil putting in the creating directory module, I'm making this as a variable here. So if you don't want Sunil in future, or if you want to name your name, you put your name here instead of changing everywhere where we use Sunil. Okay, my user is Sunil here, or my user here. This user will be updated everywhere in the playbook where we call this. This is the website name. Website name is nothing named this as my website name. This is my first playbook, and my website name in this is my second playbook, which means when we execute this playbook, and if we start a browser, access the URL, we should get my second playbook instead of my first playbook. So the index.html, which is this is doing something in the index.html, that we will discuss this. And here I am instead of mentioning in the previous playbook, what we did, we just mentioned httpd package. It will install the package available, the latest package available in our repository. But here, if you need any specific package of a version, this is not HTTP. If you want some other RPM, some Java or something, so you can specify here, specify in the vars. So this is my variable, which is httpd_version_7. I will explain you what is 6 and 7, 7 and 6 here. And this is the version I need to be installed on. This is the version I'm declaring here for this variable. Which means the 7, what I meant for 7 is Red Hat 7, basically Red Hat 7. From here you can see EL7, and for 6 I need this package, for 7 I need this package, for Red Hat 7 I need this package. That's what I'm meaning with this, and for 6 I need this package. I don't need other packages or latest or other package. Okay, if this package is not there, it will not, Handlers. Here we will discuss something about handlers. Before that, handlers is what we explained in our documentation. Handlers are just tasks. If you see handlers, this is the, if you see tasks here, only the handlers and tasks, there is no difference here. So if you see here, this is one of the module, which is file module we are calling and executing some task. The same thing we are doing here. This name, name we are giving, and a module. We use service module and we restart httpd. And where we use handlers, that we will, it will be using in our playbook. That let's go through this. We will be knowing that. Okay, tasks. Here our tasks starts. First, create directory. Only difference with the previous one is instead of my name, which is Sunil, we use the variable which we have already declared here. So how we call this variable, using this double bracket braces and variable name. So what it will do, create a folder. This is just name, right? Name of the playbook, name of the task, create a folder home user, and it will create a it is using file module here, and it is creating a home directory called home with a variable user is basically Sunil here. So it will create a directory with this variable. Okay, Now it's creating a user. Here also we can declare, instead of this we can use this user, and here also that is the usage of this variables. So if you want to update username, we just update here, that's all. It will be updated everywhere. Okay, here creating a user and creating a user here, this is same step what we use user module, everything. Only we use this thing is we use variable. Okay, this command maybe you can change, and so here also you can declare a variable Sunil for testing, like that something. Okay, and here we configure pseudo role for this user. Here we use call the variables here. Okay, everywhere we are calling. Now there is a few things, I have added few more features of Ansible. I have added here, which is what we declared here, which is one for HTTP version 7, Red Hat 7, and 1.4.6. And here if you see from here, okay, here till that we already discussed, and from here we have two tasks for HTTP package installation, one for CentOS 7 and one for CentOS 6, right? Okay, so CentOS 7, this is the package we have declared in the variable section that we are calling here. Here we are calling that 7, and it is checking a condition here when we need to execute this this task, when Ansible distribution major version is equal to 7. What is this Ansible distribution major version, which is actually a global variable that we already discussed. So Ansible host 01-m is module, and if we executed this command earlier in this section, grep, I'm just filtering this, not this one, Ansible distribution major version. Okay, let's see, I'm executing against host 01, our remote host. Okay, it's unreachable version, sorry. It's because I have restored this host, my host 01 node to its previous state, I say, because we need to clear up everything. So it lost the SSH key, copy ID, I will do that first. Now I will execute the same again. Okay, and if I execute the full one that I executed in, this is the one, so Ansible distribution major version, this is a fact actually, this is a global variable that Ansible is checking when we execute a playbook. Okay, and this we are using that global variable here to execute some specific task. For example, it is checking we are using this variable, Ansible distribution major version 7, which means we are calling this variable here when Ansible distribution major version equal to 7, execute this. And when Ansible distribution major version is 6, execute this. That's all. This is the global variable. This is local variable. Everything is coming here. So this is our one of global variable. So global variable is already there. It's already declared, and we are checking whether 6 or 7 using a global variable and executing the respective package for that version using a local variable in the playbook. I hope it's clear. Now move to the next important one, which is copying a template here. So we have a static index.html earlier in the playbook, in the previous playbook that I have created using cat command, and we served the web page with some static contents. So for example, in some cases, not only for web servers, for any reason we need a dynamic content which is in the file. So what we do, we use a module, there is a module called template, and this is the template module will use Jinja templates. Here I will explain a bit about the template which is coming down. And here the source is, instead of index.html, I am using a template, J2 template, which is index.html dot J2. Okay, and this is the destination, this is source, and this is the destination. Rest everything is, earlier we used a copy module, now we are using template module. Okay, and here we, or we can use file module also, file module using instead of template. Okay, but here in this for if you are using Jinja 2, we can use only template module. Okay, template module using this, and destination is this, and this is the steps, ownership and permission change. Okay, I'm using one more thing, which is notify restart D. This is what these handlers do. Okay, if you see the top of this playbook, there is a handler declaration here, right? So this is our handler. So this handler will be executed only when there is a call like this in the playbook, in the task, in the main task. So what it is doing, so I'm changing some configuration file for index.html. We don't need to restart HTTPD, but I'm just doing this for just, we are learning Ansible, right? So not HTTPD. Okay, so here when we edit something in this config, for example, suppose this is a configuration file, and after this configuration file change, we need to restart some services, right? Most of the cases we need to restart services. So and that services should be restarted only when there is a change. We can use a service module and make it restarted. That what will happen? At the end of the playbook, instead of this, at the end of the playbook, you can call the service module and restart the service. But what will happen? Every time the service will be restarted when you are executing the playbook. One of the things we need to remind every time when you are writing playbook is, we need to make a playbook that is that will not re-execute the steps that is already executed earlier. So when you are running a playbook second time, which is the first time was successful, and if you are running this second time when you are running a playbook, it should not be there should not be anything that will be re-executed. That is not good, right? So it might crash the existing application or something. So it is better to use this methodology when you are writing a playbook. And there is one more thing, I will explain this later. Okay. Here I'm notifying, here this is the use of main usage of handler. So we don't need to restart HTTPD every time. Restart HTTPD whenever there is a change in the configuration. Okay, and if there is no change, don't execute this handlers. Simply don't execute this handlers. That's all we are talking to our playbook, our Ansible. Okay, using this playbook. Okay, this is a template. And the last one is service is enabled and started. So this is the same one what we did earlier. Now let's discuss about the Jinja 2 template. Okay, I'm doing, there are many things that you can do with Jinja 2 template. I'm not going too deep. I'm just doing a simple one, which is this actually. Okay, this is a format of Jinja 2 template here. I am checking a condition where website name is defined or not. OK, Okay, this Jinja2 template will be executed only if the website name variable is defined. This is the format of this condition check. Okay, if website what is website name? Website name is a variable what we declared here. Okay, if you remember my second playbook, so we declared already. So it is checking the variable is defined or not, and if it is defined, it is texting like this. Okay, this is our this is a file out to a remote server, right? So these are from this to this is static content, and here we are calling a variable here inside a Jinja2 template. We can call variables that we have already declared, and here again a static content, and check the and close the if condition, and we can use for while many things we can use in Jinja2 template. This is a basic example of Jinja2 template. Okay, and same thing what we did earlier, which is update the inventory file. Okay, now we can run this playbook. We can make a copy of this enabling. Yes, till this is playbook. I'm going to my Ansible management server, and I have already created a directory here. I'm going to create here my second playbook. Yes. Okay, cd. I'm going to my directory here. Okay, now we have this. Now I'm going to create a file, my second playbook, with the same one what we discussed so far. Okay, my file, my main playbook file is created. Now I'm copying the Jinja template. index.html. Okay, here I copy my Jinja template that we discussed already. Now I have index.html, and now we need inventory. Instead of localhost, I'm changing to host 01, that is my server remote host. Okay, now we run the playbook with our updated features. There is no changes in the task, but we added more features in the playbook, like including variables, Jinja2 template and handlers, and some global variables. There is an error. Let me check. What is this user? Okay, there is something in the user. Okay, there is one problem here that I have corrected here, which is it should be in the double quotes, else it will not work. That is the syntax. We edited this, and there is a syntax error we are getting. Okay, I have edited this. Let's try running the playbook again. Yeah, now it's running. My play name is Jinja, using many things. Okay, creating home folder. If you see this is changed. I restored my host. This is a new host. It's almost like a new host, and it's running all these tasks in my new host. Let's wait for the HTTP installation. more thing, if you see here, it's this is one of the variable that we called here in this area. Okay, so it's Sunil, it's creating that, it's actually calling the variable. So in the previous playbook, we use static content. Okay, let's wait for HTTP installation. Yes, this HTTP installation is completed. I posted my video during that time, and see, if you see here, there is an error. I will explain this. I know what is problem here. If you see the HTTP installation, one step this is changed, and second step which is skipped, which means it is skipped because this is CentOS, this is for Red Hat 6, it's not for me, it's I'm 7, right? So this is where we check the condition using global variable. Okay, now let's go to our error. This is the same error that because we use index.html.j2 in the if you see here, this is j2 file, but what we created is index.html. So I need to rename it .j2. Okay, now let's run again. It's already created folder, so there is no changes here. It's just okay here, not just okay, which means not doing anything. It's checking the package, it's okay, skipping because it's Archil 7. Now it's copying the template, it's changed, it's now worked. It started web server and running the handler. Because why it's running the handler? Because we changed the template, that's why we are. So this is till this is task, and here it's running handler. Okay, and handler is also executed here. Okay, if there is no change in the configuration file, the handler will not be executed. Now let's check our web server. See, this is our first playbook, and our web server, new web server is ready. Web server is installed with my second playbook using variables, Jinja, and handlers. Okay, let's try again running the playbook. See what will happen. Whenever you are writing a playbook, we should remember, as I said earlier, we should remember when the step is already executed, it should not be executed. That's the SA method I follow every time. It's a best practice. So we should be checking. Also, there is nothing changed, which means there is no handlers running here. See, because I haven't changed anything here, there is no changes here. If there is any changes, then only the handlers will be executed. Here there is no changes, so there is no need of executing handlers. There is no handlers and there is nothing, so all are good. You are good. Okay, we have completed our second playbook also. Okay, I'm closing this. Now our last part, which is my first Ansible role. Okay, before that I will clear my VM to, I will clear everything in my host 02, and will be back. I'm pausing my video. Okay, I have a new host 01 here, which is basically almost a fresh installation. I restored to previous state. Okay, we are going to do the same tasks what we have done for my first playbook and second playbook, but using a different methodology here. Here we use, if you see our previous playbook, this is a basic playbook, so we can understand at least. But if you see the complete thing, everything in a single file, and whenever this is very difficult to manage if the playbook is growing or is a huge, many hundreds of steps four different servers are running. So what we do to organize it, that is where we use roles, Ansible roles. Okay, here, what is Ansible role? That we already explained a bit about Ansible role, and here we convert the previous playbook to a role in here. Okay, that's what we are going to do. Okay, first of all, role is an organized way of writing playbooks. Okay, when doing, we will be going in deeper. So I'm going to create a new directory in my first Ansible role. Okay. Okay, I'm in this directory now. Now we will create a role. Role is nothing. We organize the playbooks that we did earlier in a much better way. Okay, so first of all, this one I already done. I'm in this directory, and I'm going to create a few directories here to organize it. Okay, I have created tasks, vars, handlers, templates, files. From the name itself, you will be understanding what is it. So in the task ls, we have this many directories. Files, there will be static files. Handlers, all the handlers will be here. Tasks, only the tasks will be here. Templates, only the templates will be here. And vars, four vars. So we created this directories, and now what we do, we create a main file called main.yaml in tasks folder. There is no changes in any steps, but we are organizing it. So we create here a file in tasks folder. Okay, and the rest everything is same, except adding a few more steps that I will explain a bit at the end. If you see the previous playbook, in the main playbook that we run, we have many different tasks and all things that is not here. So this main.yaml under tasks is only the tasks. So we don't have any other things other than tasks. We have only tasks here, that what are the tasks to be executed. Okay, these two things I have added in this playbook. That is the only difference with the previous one, which is which I will explain this a bit, which is registering a result. So it is useful to show this command, what we will do, show the command of I'm going to use a module called shell here, and I'm executing this command on the there's a module called shell to execute some commands on the remote host. So I'm using that module to execute systemctl status httpd. This is to check the status of httpd. And if you want to see the result, what we will do, we will register. This is actually a variable. We are saving this output in a variable called result, and using it, there is a one more module called debug. Using a debug module, displaying the here, this is the format in the debug. If you look for the debug module here, you can see the in the Ansible documentation, you can see all the options here, options in that. And I'm just displaying the output. This is the this is one of the function here, std out underscore lines. This is displaying the std out of this command. There will be std out, std error, std many things in the output, and we display only the std out lines with this debug module. So what we are doing here basically is displaying the status of httpd. That's all. Okay, and this all HTTPD service. And this is one more debug module, one more usage of a debug module, where if you want to display a message in the screen, that you see, we can use a message in the debug module. This is the message I'm going to display with this playbook. Okay, now let's we have created this file, this this file is the task file is created. Now I'm going to create vars file. So we are declaring all the variables in the vars directory main.yml file. Here this is the same, exactly same variable, but I'm declaring in a vars directory. Okay, here we use handless. Here we do the handless in the handless folder with the main.yml, all with main.yml. Okay, handless is done. Now templates in the templates folder. Okay, the same thing what we discussed earlier. Now this is not used in the playbook, but just if you have some static content, static files, you can use this. Okay, now the only thing is here is we have these things here. See, if you see the structure of this, under files I have an index.html, under handless I have main.yml, under tree I have main.yml again, and in templates I have the ginger template, index.html.j2, and vars it's main.yml. So how we do execute this playbook? For that we need another one more playbook where we tell Ansible what we need to do. Okay, here the I'm naming as my first Ansible role.yml, and here I will explain this. Here this is the same format what we used earlier. Here we name my first Ansible role, here the host, here we declare the host, here we declare the tasks. There are two tasks to include the tasks. Include the tasks. We need a variable that we are calling here from this file. So it will look for this variables vars main.yml file, and it will include in this task. And import tasks. This is include vars. This is import tasks. So it will look for this file, and this file will be imported into our main playbook. And if you want to import a handless. Handless is basically a task that we discussed already, and we are under the handless section we are calling this file to import into the main playbook. That's all what we need to do. This is very simple to understand. The name is same, the host, this is the host we are going to execute, this is the tasks, and tasks we use this variable file, and this is the main task file, and this is our handler file. This is easily understandable if someone is looking into your playbook. And inventory is exactly same. We don't change anything in the inventory. Okay, one more thing I'm using here in the inventory file is we will declare host 01. One more feature I have added, Ansible feature I have added here is, here also we can declare variables for remote hosts. This is one of the server group as we discussed earlier, and for server groups the vars variables are this. Okay, we can declare variables here also for the specific node group. Okay, for example, if we have one more node group, this is very useful, huh? So this is my host 02, and here we just mention vars, and website name is same name with vars. So Here we can host two. So this is the usage. So for this host, for host under this section, we use this variable. And if there is another host that we need another variable that we can use like this. So for the host 01, instead of host 02, okay. So this is the host under this. I will name like this to avoid confusions. Okay, so this is for my host 02, and this is my host, and this is the variable applicable only for the host under this section. We have host 02 1 again like that. So all the hosts will be coming here. So this is this I'm including here, and saving this file. Okay, I have created the inventory. Now let's run the playbook. This is the final playbook that we are going to do with this tutorial. Now let's check. So we have files index.html in the main file. Main my first role is here. That is here, and this is the directory structure of a role. Okay, so let's execute this. My Ansible. Okay, started playbook. My first Ansible role. It's the exact same thing that it's doing as earlier, and this is here. It's it's including var. See, it's including var, and here the same thing, but in a different way actually. Here sudo role. So we wait for this installation. Okay, installation of HTTP is completed. Now it's skipping for 6, copying template, starting web server. Here we saw something that we didn't saw earlier. Let's explain that a bit. Okay, here this is the task that we have introduced in this role, newly introduced in this role, which is execute command to check HTTP status, and which is actually what it is doing. It is here it is. Okay, here it is. This is the command. This is I'm using shell module as I said earlier, and it is registering the value to result. Okay, and what we are doing here, this is a debug module. Here we are using debug module, and we are displaying the output of this std out of this. That is the output of systemctl output, systemctl command output, status command output. That is what we are seeing here, and from this we can see this service is started and active. Okay, and I'm using one more debug module, which is to message, to give you a custom message. That is, hello friends, thanks for watching this video. I hope you will find this tutorial useful. Please like and share your feedback. Don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. That's all guys, that's all I have prepared. I hope you find this tutorial useful, and you will be able to start working on Ansible from now. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye. Have a great day.